Hi everyone, it's Emmett from Pie My Life Up. In this video, we'll be showing you how you can install the Rockstar Games Launcher on the Steam Deck. Installing the official launcher will give you access to any of the games that you have bought directly through Rockstar. One of the biggest advantages of using a Steam Deck is that they give you full access to the desktop, which allows you to install software that isn't provided through the Steam Store. To begin this process, you'll want to switch to desktop mode. To do this, bring up the Steam menu by pressing the Steam button, then select the power option, and then you'll want to select the switch to desktop option at the bottom. Once in desktop mode, you'll want to open a web browser. In our case, we will be using Firefox. With the web browser open, tap the address bar and press the X button to bring up the on-screen keyboard. Now use this to type in https://socialclub.rockstargames.com/rockstar-games-launcher/. Press R2 to submit this address and then press B to close the on-screen keyboard. Now on this page, click the Download for Windows button. Once the Rockstar Games Launcher is downloaded to your Steam Deck, you'll want to open the Steam client. You can open this by double tapping the Steam icon on the desktop. With Steam open, click Add a Game in the bottom left hand corner and then click Add a non-Steam game. In the dialog box that appears, you'll need to click the Browse option. Now with the Browse screen open, use the sidebar to change to the Downloads folder and then find and double click the Rockstar Games Launcher.exe. Now scroll through this list and verify that the Rockstar Games Launcher has now been selected. Once you're short selected, click the Add Selected Programs button. With the Games Launcher installer now added to our Steam library, we'll need to change it to run through the Proton compatibility layer. This compatibility layer is what allows you to run Windows-based applications on your Steam Deck. Now tap Library in the top menu to change your Steam library and then find and select the Rockstar Games Launcher.exe entry. Once you have the Rockstar Games Launcher selected within your Steam Deck's game library, click the cog icon and then click the Properties option. With the Properties screen open, use the sidebar to change to the Compatibility tab. Now on this screen, tick the Force the Use of a Specific Steam Play Compatibility Tool checkbox. Once ticked, we can change it to run under Proton by clicking the Select box and then selecting the Proton Experimental option. We are using Proton Experimental as it tends to come with the latest fixes. With this all done, we can now hit the X button to close out of the Properties menu. Now begin installing the Rockstar Games Launcher to your Steam Deck by clicking the Play button. This first screen will ask you to select your language. Select your language and then click the Continue button. If you find the controls of your Steam Deck to be unresponsive, hold down the Steam button while performing these actions. You'll now see a screen listing all the different pieces of software that the Rockstar Games Launcher will install. It will also reference some of the guidelines that you will have to abide by using this launcher. If you're happy to proceed, click the Continue button. This next screen will ask you to agree to the Rockstar Games Terms of Service. If you agree to these terms, click the I accept Rockstar's Terms of Service and then click the Continue button. You'll now be asked where you want the Rockstar Games Launcher to be installed to. As this directory exists within the Proton compatibility layer that Steam's automatically set up, you'll just want to click the Continue button. Once the Rockstar Games Launcher has been installed, you'll need to untick the Run Rockstar Games Launcher on Close option and then click the Close button. There's a few more adjustments we have to make before you begin using this launcher. Back in your Steam library, click the cog icon and then click the Properties option. Now, the first thing you'll want to do is rename this shortcut. Double tap the text box and then press X to bring up the on-screen keyboard. In our case, we'll be naming this Rockstar Games Launcher. Once you have typed out a new name, press B to close the on-screen keyboard. The next step is to change the launch target from the installer to the Rockstar Games Launcher that you just installed. To set this, click the Browse button. Now, within this dialog, you'll want to first change to your home directory. Once you're in the home directory, click the Settings button, and then ensure that the Show Hidden Files checkbox is enabled. Once it is enabled, open the .local directory, and then open the Share folder, and then the Steam folder, and then after that, look for the Steam Apps directory, and then the Combat Data folder, and then in on this screen, you'll want to make sure that the folders are sorted by date. There should be a down arrow on the date column if it's sorted by date. If it isn't pointing down, tap it until it is. Now the Proton directory that you're after should be at the top of this list. Once in this folder, change into the PFX directory and then into drive _C and then into program files, and then you should see Rockstar Games. Open it up and then open the launcher directory within it. And then finally, you should see a file called launcher.exe. Double tap it to select it as the launch target. With the launch target now set to the Rockstar Games Launcher, double tap the target text box until all the text is highlighted. Once highlighted, press L2 to bring up the context menu and then select the copy option. Now double tap the starting text box and then press L2 again and then select the paste option this time. Now we will need to remove the launcher.exe reference at the end of this line. Press the X button to open the on-screen keyboard and then hit backspace until launcher.exe is removed. You can close the on-screen keyboard by pressing the B button. The final step we need to do here is add a double quote to the start and end of both the target and starting text boxes. We need to do this as the spaces within the folder paths can cause issues. Once you have finished doing this, you can now exit out of the property screen by hitting the X button. Our next step is to create a folder in which you will store your Rockstar games outside of the Proton compatibility layer. To begin this process, open the Dolphin folder browser by clicking the folder icon in the taskbar. With the File Explorer now open, ensure that you are in the home directory. Once you're in the right place, press L2 to bring up the context menu, and then hover over the Create New option and then click Folder. Now press X to bring up the on-screen keyboard and type in a name for this folder. In our case, we will call ours Rockstar Games. Once done, press R2 to create this folder and then press B to close the on-screen keyboard. With the folder now created, we will want to create a symbolic link between this and the Proton compatibility layer. To do this, click the Split button and then double tap Home and then highlight the text in the text box and press L2 to bring up the context menu and then select the paste option. You'll then need to bring up the on-screen keyboard to delete launcher.exe. Once done, click the tick button to change to this directory. Now on the right hand side of the screen, click program files and then click drive_C. You'll now want to drag the Rockstar Games folder from the left hand side to the right hand side of the screen. Now, click the Link Here option. You have now created a symbolic link between your Rockstar Games folder in your home directory and the virtual C drive that the Rockstar Games Launcher can see. You'll now want to return to gaming mode by double tapping the Return to Gaming Mode icon on your desktop. Once you're back in gaming mode, open up the Steam menu by pressing the Steam button and then select the Library option. Now, press R1 until the non-Steam tab is selected. Now, you should see an option called Rockstar Games Launcher. Select it to continue. All you need to do now to launch the Rockstar Games Launcher on your Steam Deck is to hit the Play button. When this launcher first runs, it will install any services it requires, as well as update itself to the latest release. This process can take a few minutes to complete. You'll now need to enter the email address for your Rockstar Games account and then the password. The on-screen keyboard should automatically appear if you tap into either of these text boxes, but if it doesn't, press the Steam button and X at the same time to bring up the on-screen keyboard. With both your email and password set, you'll then want to tick the auto sign in checkbox. Once done, click the sign in button to log into your account. When you first launch the Rockstar Games Launcher, it will ask if you want to scan for installations. As this launcher is running within its own Proton layer, you'll be unaware of anything else that you have installed on your system. So select the Cancel option. You have now successfully set up the Rockstar Games Launcher on your Steam Deck. To give you an example of how this all works, we are going to install Grand Theft Auto San Andreas to our Steam Deck by hitting the Install Now button. We'll now be prompted on where we want to install this game to our Steam Deck. Hit the Browse button, and then ensure that you select the Rockstar Games folder that we set up earlier. Once selected, click OK. We can now begin installing Grand Theft Auto San Andreas through the Rockstar Games Launcher by clicking the Install button. Now all we need to do is sit back and wait for the launcher to install this game onto our Steam Deck. While San Andreas downloads and installs to our Steam Deck, let's launch a different game that we have already installed previously to our Steam Deck. In this case, we'll be running GTA Vice City on our Steam Deck using the Rockstar Games Launcher. Depending on the game that you are running, you may need to readjust the Steam input options. Luckily, the vast majority of Rockstar's games have been built with controllers in mind, which means it should work fine out of the box in most cases. Hopefully at this point, you will also have managed to install the Rockstar Games Launcher onto your Steam Deck. If you found this guide to be helpful, be sure to give us a thumbs up and subscribe. Until next time, have a good one.